Muhammad Ghori, after the fall of Ghazni kingdom, the Ghori defeated themselves independent. In the meantime, Muhammad Ghori, the governor of Ghazni, attacked India. As mentioned earlier, he was defeated by Prithviraj Chauhan in the first battle of Tehran. Yet, the next year, Ghori defeated Prithviraj. The political instability of India, the disunity among the Rajput kings, and also the energetic and ambitious invasions of Turks were the reasons of Turkish success in India. When North India was facing the turmoil of the Turkish invasions, the kingdoms in South India were comparatively peaceful. One of those kingdoms that flourished there was Rashtrakutas. The Rashtrakutas had an empire which was extended from South Gujarat, Malwa and Behelkand in the north to Tanjore in the south. Danti Durga was the founder of the Rashtrakuta dynasty. He defeated the Chalukyas of Badami. He was succeeded by his uncle Krishna. The famous Kailasha temple at Ellora was built by him. Dhruva, the younger son of Krishna, defeated the Pratiharas and the Palas among Dhruva, the younger son of Krishna I, defeated the Pratiharas and the Palas I in the 9th century AD and made Manyakheta as his capital. He had a long reign of 66 years. He was a patron of learning and wrote Kavi Raja Marga in Kannada. The Rashtrakuta dynasty came to an end when Chalukyas of Kalyan defeated them. Now we will see the case study of the Cholas. In class 6, we have studied about the three powerful Tamil kingdoms which ruled between 1st and 3rd centuries. The Chola kings were one among them. After that, a few centuries, the Cholas faced the steep decline. It was only in the 9th century AD that the Cholas rose to power again and became one of the most powerful and cultured dynasty of India. In fact, the age of the Cholas, 850 to 1200 AD, is considered as a golden age of Tamil culture. Rajaraja Chola was and his son Rajendra Chola I made the Chola dynasty powerful. Under them, for the first time, South India was politically united. Now we will see about the Rajaraja Chola. Rajaraja Chola was an ambitious king. He defeated the Pandyas and Eastern Chalukyas of Vengi. The Western Chalukya king was forced to make peace with Rajaraja Chola. Chalukya even defeated Kerala, Ceylon and the Maldives. He had good relations with Sri Vijaya, the maritime empire of Sumatra. Under Rajaraja Chola's administration was reorganized and great importance was given to the navy, which helped in his expeditions. The magnificent temple of Bihardeswara was built by Rajaraja Chola. In 1012 AD, Rajaraja Chola declared his son Rajendra Chola I as his successor and he became the king. Rajendra Chola I, like his father Rajaraja Chola, followed the policy of expansion. He defeated Vengi, Malaya and Ceylon. He also defeated Kalinga and led an expedition to the valley of Ganga. He conquered Bihar and defeated the Pala king of Bengal. These victories brought him the title of Gangai Kondan, conqueror of Ganga. Moreover, he also established a new capital named Ganga.